Good morning. In this class, we will try to recall all the ideas that we have learnt in dual nature of radiation and matter. Dual nature of radiation and matter. See, you know this chapter mainly focuses on understanding electron emission and very specifically photoelectric emission. I have told you what is meant by electron emission. Read about electron emission when you are preparing for your examinations. See, we know what is meant by electron emission. It is the process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by supplying suitable amount of energy to it. You must stress upon the term suitable amount of energy. So the process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by supplying suitable amount of energy to it is called as electron emission. And we know there are three types of electron emission. Go through the types of electron emission, that is important. The types of electron emission are thermionic emission, field emission and the photoelectric emission. Thermionic emission, field emission and the photoelectric emission. These are the three types of electron emission. We know what is meant by thermionic emission. It is a process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by supplying suitable amount of heat energy to the metal surface. Suppose if this is a metal surface, we know metal surface generally contains large number of free electrons. These electrons are just free to move throughout the volume of this metal. The metal surface olagade move aagabodu, but metal surface bittu horag barlik aagalla anthe. If an electron tries to come out of the metal surface acquires positive charge. We know whenever a body loses an electron, it acquires positive charge. So when this electron tries to come out of the metal surface acquires positive charge and pulls the electron back onto the metal surface. This behavior of metal surface is called as surface barrier. It is known as surface barrier. That means the surface of the metal itself opposes the electron to go out of the metal surface. The surface does not allow the electron to go out of it. This behavior of metal surface is called a surface barrier. Anyhow, in order to eject this electron completely out of the metal surface, we need to supply energy to it. Energy may be supplied in the form of heat. So the process of ejection of electrons from a metal surface by supplying suitable amount of heat energy to it is called as thermionic emission. I have even told you electrons can be ejected out of metal surface by applying suitable high electric field. Suitable high electric field. See, even by applying suitable high electric field, we are able to eject the electrons out of the metal surface. That process of ejecting electrons out of a metal surface by applying suitable high electric fields is called as field emission. We will learn how we can eject electrons out of metal surface by applying suitable high electric fields in potential capacitance chapter. We'll learn about anyway. And I have told you what is meant by photoelectric emission. The process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by allowing light of suitable frequency to fall on it. That is important. By allowing light of suitable frequency. This must be used. Should not say photoelectric emission, or you should not define photoelectric emission as the process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by allowing light of suitable energy. No, you must say the process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by allowing the light of suitable frequency to fall on it. We know light is made up of tiny elastic particles called photons. Energy of a photon is given by E is equals to h nu. See, we know that this is the energy of a photon. Energy of a photon. Observe, H is Planck's constant. So we can say energy is directly proportional to frequency of radiation. Nu is called frequency. More is the frequency of light, more is the energy of light. Less is the frequency of light, less is the energy of light. So we always define energy of light in terms of its frequency. Now light the energy bagge maatada necessity illa yakandre energy ne frequency mel depend aagutha. More is the frequency of light, more is the energy. Less is the frequency of light, less is the energy. So we should always define photoelectric emission as the process of ejecting electrons from a metal surface by allowing light of suitable frequency to fall on it. So this is regarding the types of electron emission. Go through it. What is electron emission? What are the different types of electron emission? Define. Try to go through the definitions of each type of electron emission. And after this, go through some of the basic definitions such as work function. See, these are some important definitions which you must learn. Work function. See, I have told you, suppose if this is a metal surface generally contains large number of free electrons. I have told you, these are the electrons which are free to move on the surface of the electron, but they are not free to come out. They are not free to come out. As a result, in order to remove these electrons out of the metal surface, we need to supply energy to them. Suppose I need to remove this electron out of the metal surface. And in order to remove this electron out of the metal surface, I go on supplying the energy to it. Let us suppose I initially supply an energy of 1 electron volt. I supply an energy of 1 electron volt to this electron. And I observe the electron doesn't come out. Next I increase the energy to 1.5 electron. The electron doesn't still come out of the metal surface. I increase the energy to 2 electron. The electron doesn't come out. I make it 2.1 electron volt and I observe the electron completely comes out of the metal surface. The electron completely comes out of the metal surface. 2.2 electron volt supply madidru electron horage bartade. 2.3 electron volt supply madidru electron horage bartade. Hagadru what is the minimum amount of energy required to eject the electron from the metal surface? Kadame kadame andru eshtu beku nodkonri. What is the minimum amount of energy required to eject the electron from the metal surface? See, at 1 electron volt electron was not ejected. At 1.5 electron volt electron was not ejected. And at 2 electron volt the electron was not ejected. At 2.1 electron volt the electron got ejected from the metal surface. So this is the minimum amount of energy required. Minimum amount of energy required to eject the electron from the metal surface. This is known as the minimum amount of energy. This is the work function of this metal. We call 2.1 electron volt as the work function of this metal. So if I say 2.1 electron volt is work function of metal X, what do you understand? When I say 2.1 electron volt is work function of metal X, what do you understand? You have to understand that a minimum of 2.1 electron volts of energy is required to eject an electron from that metal surface. A metal surface X in the 1 electron horak tegibeku antandre minimum andru 2.1 electron volts of energy kodbeku. So work function is defined as the minimum amount of energy. Work function is defined as minimum amount of energy required to eject an electron from the metal surface. And I have told you work function is given by W is equals to H mu naught. This is the formula for work function. In order to calculate the work function of any metal, you can make use of this formula, W is equals to H into mu naught, where H is Planck's constant and mu naught is called as threshold frequency. Mu naught is called threshold frequency. We also know what is meant by threshold frequency. We have defined it, isn't it? So this is the definition of work function. Go through it. So after understanding what is work function, also go through the definition of threshold frequency. The definition of threshold frequency is quite important. Threshold frequency represented by mu naught. This must be read as mu. Okay, zero is mu naught. Threshold frequency is the minimum frequency of incident light below which photoelectric emission does not take place. See, threshold frequency is the minimum frequency of incident light below which photoelectric emission does not take place. We have discussed in detail regarding threshold frequency when we were discussing the chapter. So I have told you threshold frequency is the minimum frequency of incident light. ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಟ್ ದು ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ. ಇದು ಈ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿಗಿಂತ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಥ್ರೆಶೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಬಿಲೋ ವಿಚ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಿಫೈನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಥ್ರೆಶೋಲ್ಡ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ಥ್ರೆಶೋಲ್ಡ್ See, threshold wavelength is exactly opposite to threshold frequency. Threshold frequency is minimum frequency below which photoelectric emission does not take place. Aa frequency aadmele photoelectric emission aagutte. But threshold wavelength enadala, it is the maximum wavelength of incident light. Threshold wavelength is the maximum wavelength of incident light. Above which photoelectric emission does not take place. One maximum wavelength irtade, aa wavelength kinta incident light du wavelength enadru jaasti idre photoelectric emission agala. Suppose here is a metal surface and I say the threshold wavelength of this metal surface is 5000 angstrom. The threshold wavelength of this metal surface is 5000 angstrom andre as long as the wavelength of incident light is 5000 angstrom, photoelectric emission takes place. Suppose wavelength of incident light is 4500 angstrom, photoelectric emission aagutade nodri elli varu aagutade andre 5000 angstrom varu aagutade. 5000 angstrom aadmele photoelectric emission agala. Adike nanu helthirodu threshold wavelength is the maximum wavelength above which photoelectric emission does not take place. This is the maximum wavelength up to which photoelectric emission can take place. 5000 angstrom varu photoelectric emission aagutade. Once the wavelength of incident light becomes greater than 5000 angstrom, photoelectric emission will not take place. Let us suppose light of wavelength 5010 angstrom is incident on the metal surface. Observe, the threshold wavelength of this metal surface was 5000 angstrom and now light of wavelength 5010 angstrom is incident on the metal surface. Will photoelectric emission take place? Under the answer is no. This is the maximum wavelength up to which photoelectric emission can take place, isn't it? So threshold wavelength is the maximum wavelength above which photoelectric emission does not take place. So go through the definitions of threshold frequency and definition of threshold wavelength. These are important. After all understanding what is threshold frequency and threshold wavelength, go through the definition of one electron hole. One electron hole. See, this is an important definition for one mark. one electron. See, I have told you, the energy of the subatomic particles like electron, proton, neutron, all these are measured in units of electron. Joule ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಜರ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಇವುಗಳ ಎನರ್ಜಿನ ಆಯ್ತಾ. ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಬ್ ಅಟಮಿಕ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಜನರಲಿ ಮೆಜರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ನ ಮಿಲಿಯನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಮೆಜರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಜನರಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೆಜರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಬ್ ಅಟಮಿಕ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಒನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಗೇನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಅನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಸಿ, one electron volt is the energy gained by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. iga illondu negatively charged plate ade anta illondu positively charged plate ade yavaga namatra one positively charged plate matte one negatively charged plate irthudo ee eradu plates madhya potential difference bartide. ಎರಡು ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಮಧ್ಯ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ದ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ 1. ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟನ್ಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್, ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಷ್ಟದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಎರಡು ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ 1 volt. ಓಕೆ, ಈ ಎರಡು ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಇನ್ನು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. ಈ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ರಿಪೆಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಬೈ ಅಪ್ಲೈಂಗ್ ಅನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ರಿಪೆಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಅಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಬೈ ಎಕ್ಸರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಯಾವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೋ ಅವಾಗ ಆ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಗೆ ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಷನ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ಬೈ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಟಿಂಗ್. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಟಿಂಗ್. ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರೋದೆ ಅಂತ ಅರ್ಥ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅಂತ. ಅವಾಗ ಅದ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಯಾವ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ? ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬಂತು ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು ನೀವು. ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಗೇನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಅನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಟೆಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಎ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ 1 volt. 1 volt ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಒಂದು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಲರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬರ್ತದೋ ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು 1 electron volt ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ joule. See, whenever an electron is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt, it acquires a kinetic energy of 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ joule. ಅಷ್ಟು ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅದರ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜೌಲ್. 1 mark ನ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ರೈಟ್ ಆ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ವೋಲ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜೌಲ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. This is the relationship between electron volt and joule. So, 1 electron volt is the energy gained by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. So, go through the definition of 1 electron volt. So, with this idea of a threshold of frequency and threshold wavelength, we will try to understand the experimental study of photoelectric effect. Experimental study of photoelectric effect. See, this may be asked in 3 marks. We know that the experimental arrangement used to study photoelectric effect consists of an evacuated glass tube fitted with a side window. This is a side window and this is an evacuated glass tube. Inside this evacuated glass tube, 2 metal plates, one is emitter and the other is the collector. these two metal plates are fixed inside this evacuated glass tube. These two metal plates are connected to a high voltage battery. Now, we allow a monochromatic light to fall on the metal surface. When monochromatic light is allowed to fall on this emitter surface, electrons get ejected out of it. As soon as monochromatic light is allowed to fall on this emitter surface, electrons get ejected out of it. And see, the electrons are negatively charged and this collector plate is maintained at positive potential. As a result, these electrons start moving towards the collector plate. I have told you, moving electrons always constitute current. Here, these electrons, or this is the electron that is ejected out of this emitter plate when light of suitable frequency falls on it. So, we call this electron as a photoelectron. This is called as photoelectron. And the current constituted by photoelectron is called photocurrent. So, when monochromatic light is allowed to fall on metal surface or this emitter plate, electron get ejected out. This electron start moving towards the collector plate, which constitutes what is called as photocurrent. So the movement of photoelectrons constitute photocurrent. This photocurrent will be measured by a microammeter connected in the circuit. See, this is known as microammeter. Ammeter is a device used to measure current. So the current constituted by this photoelectrons will be measured by this microammeter, and the potential difference between emitter and collector, emitter matte collector matte eshtu voltage ade annadanna illo volt meter irutada idu measure madutha. Volt meter is a device used to measure the voltage. Emitter matte collector matte eshtu voltage apply madi ee battery use madi, that will be measured by the volt meter. This is the experimental study of photoelectric effect. Experimental study of photoelectric effect describe madre andre ishte describe madu. You have to just speak about the experimental construction arrangement hagale that must be said. So the experimental arrangement consists of an evacuated glass tube fitted with a side window. Side window in the illinda we allow light to enter into the tube. When under two metal plates, one is emitter and the other is collector, fitted in this evacuated tube. Emitter is maintained at negative potential and the collector is maintained at positive potential. When monochromatic light is allowed to fall on the emitter, electrons get ejected out of it. These electrons are called as photoelectrons. The motion of these photoelectrons constitute photocurrent. This photocurrent will be measured by a microammeter connected in the circuit. And the voltage between emitter and collector is measured by the voltmeter. This is all regarding the experimental study of photoelectric effect. So if you are asked to describe the experimental study of photoelectric effect, this is how you need to describe. So I explain the experimental arrangement. Explain the experimental arrangement used. Then describe the what happens when monochromatic light is allowed to fall on the metal surface. Then speak about photocurrent. Need to tell about photocurrent. What is the device used to measure this photocurrent? Microammeter. That must be specified. and the device used to measure voltage between emitter and the collector. This voltmeter. This must be mentioned in the explanation. So this is regarding the experimental study of photoelectric effect. After all, understanding experimental study of photoelectric effect, you need to go through the laws of photoelectric effect. The laws of photoelectric effect are important. Laws of photoelectric effect. See, the laws of photoelectric effect are also called the observations of photoelectric effect. Laws of photoelectric effect are also called the observations. Write any three laws of photoelectric effect and other. Or they may also ask you to write the observations of photoelectric effect. So we know that photoelectric effect is an instantaneous process. Photoelectric effect is an instantaneous process. I have told you what is meant by instantaneous process. This means electron get ejected out. As soon as light is incident on the metal surface, electron get ejected out. There is no time lag between incidence of light and ejection of electron. Light biddu 10-15 nimisha aadmele electron eject agala. As soon as light is incident on the metal surface, electron get ejected out. That is the meaning of the statement. It is an instantaneous process. Set time minimum frequency below set time minimum frequency of incident light. Photoelectric emission does not take place below set time minimum frequency of incident light. Photoelectric emission does not take place. What is that frequency called? That must be said. That frequency is called threshold frequency. You must write about this threshold frequency. So below set time minimum frequency of incident light, photoelectric emission does not take place, and that particular frequency is known as threshold frequency. Third and fourth laws must be started by stating above threshold frequency. You must start third and fourth laws by stating above threshold frequency. Above threshold frequency andre photoelectric emission aagtirutade. Photoelectric emission aagbekadre enagtade, that must be described. So in the third and fourth laws, you start third and fourth laws by stating above threshold frequency. Above threshold frequency, photocurrent is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. Photocurrent is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. That means as you go on increasing the intensity of incident light, the photocurrent goes on increasing. That means as you go on making the light brighter and brighter, the amount of photocurrent goes on increasing. So photocurrent is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. This is the third law. And also above threshold frequency, kinetic energy of photoelectrons. So kinetic energy of photoelectrons is directly proportional to frequency of incident light. More is the frequency of incident light, more is the frequency of incident light, more is the kinetic energy of photoelectrons. You need to remember these two points. Photocurrent is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. By increasing intensity of incident light, you can increase the photocurrent. By increasing frequency of incident light, you can increase the kinetic energy of photoelectrons. So, and at the end, we know in the experimental arrangement, we had a emitter plate and we had a collector. Emitter plate is generally cathode and the collector plate will be generally the anode. We initially maintain the emitter at negative potential at the collector at positive potential. As a result of it, when light falls on the emitter, electrons get ejected out and they start moving towards the collector. Why the electrons move towards the collector, that must be clear, because this collector was maintained at positive potential. The collector positive oil work in the electron attract market. Suppose if I change the polarity of the battery, reverse mandala, and then if the collector, that is nothing but anode. Anode is nothing but collector and cathode is nothing but emitter. Suppose if I reverse the polarity of the battery, now observe, the anode is maintained at negative potential and the cathode is maintained at positive potential. Now light is allowed to fall on the emitter, electron gets ejected out, it starts moving towards the collector, but see, the collector is now maintained at negative potential. Electron negatively charged, collector negatively charged, that means the collector plate will now start repelling electron. So electron will be opposed from moving towards the collector. Electron cannot very easily move towards the collector now. After traveling certain distance, the electron will come to rest. Electron will come to stop, right? So in order to stop this electron, we need to maintain this collector or anode at a particular negative potential. When we maintain this collector at a particular negative potential, the photo current becomes zero. That means electron stops moving. Once the electron stop moving, current becomes, photo current becomes zero. That particular negative potential, applied to anode at which photo current becomes zero is called stopping potential. So at a particular negative potential applied to anode, the electron stops moving. That means the photo current becomes zero. That particular negative potential applied to anode at which photo current becomes zero is called as stopping potential. So remember the definition of stopping potential. This is quite important. And it is found that stopping potential is directly proportional to the kinetic energy of the electrons. ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದಲ್ಲ, ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಗೆ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಟಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ದ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್. ದ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಾಲಿಟಿ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇ. ಸೊ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಇ ವಿ ನಾಟ್. This is the relationship between kinetic energy and stopping potential. See, you need to remember the relationship between kinetic energy and stopping potential. Kinetic energy is equals to E V naught, where E is the charge of the electron. More is the kinetic energy of this electron, more is the negative potential required to stop this electron. Less is the kinetic energy of this electron, less is the negative potential required to stop this electron. Suppose we have an electron of kinetic energy 15 joule. For this electron with kinetic energy 15 joule, if I apply minus 1 volt potential to anode, this electron comes to rest. Suppose the kinetic energy of this electron is 30 joule, will minus 1 volt be sufficient to stop this electron? No. Under that situation, you have to increase the negative potential. How to make the negative potential equal to minus 2 volt? Adunel bandira. More is the kinetic energy of the electron, more is the stopping potential. Less is the kinetic energy of the electron, less is the stopping potential. So we can say kinetic energy is directly proportional to the stopping potential.
The proportionality constant will be E. So KE is equal to EV0 is the relationship between kinetic energy and stopping potential.
These are the laws of photoelectric effect. So photoelectric effect is an instantaneous process. You need to speak about in the second law, speak about threshold frequency. Below certain minimum frequency of incident light, photoelectric emission does not take place. This particular frequency is called as threshold frequency. Third and fourth laws must be started by stating about threshold frequency. Above threshold frequency, photocurrent is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. And fourth law, above threshold frequency, kinetic energy of photoelectrons is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. And at the end, you define what is stopping potential. Okay? So this is all regarding the loss of photoelectric effect. After all understanding the loss of photoelectric effect, we will try to learn the Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect. See, I have told you, it was Einstein who explained the observations of photoelectric effect. ಈಗ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಲ್ಲ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಬಿಲೋ ವಿತ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಥ್ರೆಶೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೀನ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಐನ್ಸ್ಟೀನ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ of photoelectric effect. Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect. See, according to Einstein, light is supposed to be made up of tiny elastic particles called photons. Einstein took this idea from Planck's quantum theory. In Planck's quantum theory, it was said that light is made up of tiny elastic particles called photons. Einstein accepted it. According to Einstein, light is made up of tiny elastic particles called photons. And he said, each photon is associated with an energy is equal to h nu. Each photon has got some energy, E is equal to h nu. One photon hatra, E is equal to h nu ashtu energy adanta. So according to Einstein, light is made up of tiny elastic particles called photons, and each photon is associated with an energy is equal to h nu. Okay. And he says each photon is capable of ejecting only one electron. One photon ge one electron na horak tegiyo shakti matra ada. So each photon can eject only one electron from the metal surface. Okay. With this idea, he said when light falls on the metal surface, the electrons in the metal surface, suppose this is an electron in the metal surface, the electron in the metal surface absorbs the photon. Electron in the metal surface absorbs the photon. After it absorbs, after the electron absorbs the photon, the electron gets the energy. The energy of the photon, see, after absorbing the energy, the electron uses the energy of the photon. E is the energy of the photon. Energy of the photon is used by the electron in two ways. Electron, photon, the energy in erad riti use maadkottare. The energy of the photon is used by the electron in two ways. A part of the energy is used by the electron to just come out of the metal surface. That amount of energy which is required by the electron to just come out of the metal surface is nothing but work function. So a part of the energy is used by the electron as work function, and the remaining part of the energy is used as kinetic energy of the electron. This is Einstein's explanation. So according to Einstein, when light is allowed to fall on the metal surface, the electrons in the metal surface absorbs the photon. The energy of the photon absorbed is used by the electron in two ways. First, a part of the energy is used by the electron to just come out of the metal surface. remaining part of the energy is used to impart kinetic energy to the electron. Suppose one photon has a 10 joule energy. Let us suppose each photon has got an energy of 10 joule. When this photon is incident on the metal surface, this electron absorbs the photon. Hagagi electron extra energy one to 10 joule energy one. 10 joule electron hag use mantra and the use mantra. First, a part of the energy is used by the electron to just come out of the metal surface. 10 joule one, say 4 joule use mantra, the electron comes out of the metal surface. In the history, 10 joule 4 joule na metal surface in the horak burly use mantra. In the electron, 6 joule, this 6 joule is used as kinetic energy by the electron. In the Munda Muag, kinetic energy vector is 6 joule kinetic energy use not. So energy of photon is used by the electron in two ways. One, a part of the energy is used by the electron to just come out of the metal surface. That is nothing but warp function. Remaining part of the energy is used by the electron as kinetic energy. We know energy of photon is hu. Energy of each photon is hu. That is equals to work function is h nu naught and kinetic energy is half m v square. This is called Einstein's photoelectric equation. This is called as Einstein's photoelectric equation. H nu is equals to h nu naught plus half m v square. This is called Einstein's photoelectric equation. Here h is Planck's constant, nu is frequency of incident light. E light energy is other frequency. Nu naught is threshold frequency. M is mass of electron ejected out. V is velocity with which electron got ejected out. This is Einstein's photoelectric equation. So go through Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect. It is important for 3 marks. 3 marks. So this is regarding Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect. After all, understanding Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect, go through the properties of photon. See, I have told you photon is a packet of energy, right? So a photon, the properties of photon, I have told you rest mass of photon is zero. You cannot find a photon at rest. Its rest mass is zero. Rest mass of photon is zero. Photons are electrically neutral. That means photons do not possess any charge. Photons are electrically neutral. Photons are not deflected by electric and magnetic fields. Electric field and magnetic field photons na deflect madalla. So photons are not deflected by electric and magnetic fields. Then photons travel with speed of light in vacuum. Vacuum olaga photons the speed it will be equal to speed of light. Right? So these are some of the properties of photon. Go through those properties of photon. Properties of photon are important. Properties of photon. Right? So, go through these ideas. These are quite important. So, after all this, you may be asked to explain the laws of photoelectric effect using Einstein's photoelectric equation. So, using Einstein's photoelectric equation, you may be asked to explain laws of photoelectric effect. See, we know that Einstein's photoelectric equation is h nu is equals to h nu naught plus half mv square. The energy of photon is used by the electron in two ways. A part of energy is used to just come out of the metal surface. This is nothing but work function. Remaining part is used as kinetic energy. Okay. So from this I can write kinetic energy of the electron, half mv square equation, but you know, half mv square can be written as h nu minus h nu naught. Correct? Half mv square is h nu minus h nu naught. And I can write the same equation as half mv square is equals to h into EVH other, EVH other, h is common, h into nu minus nu naught. This is the expression for kinetic energy of the electron.
half mv square is equal to h into nu minus mu naught. We'll call this as equation 1. This is Einstein's photoelectric equation. Using this equation, you needed to explain the laws of photoelectric effect. See, the first law of photoelectric effect is, the photoelectric effect is an instantaneous process. Einstein says why photoelectric effect is instantaneous. According to Einstein, the collision between photon and an electron, the collision between photon and an electron is a perfectly elastic collision. The collision between photon and an electron is a perfectly elastic collision. As a result, as soon as light is incident on the metal surface, light is nothing but photon. As soon as photon strikes the electron, electron gets ejected out of the metal surface. So this is the explanation provided by Einstein for photoelectric effect to be instantaneous. Photoelectric effect is an instantaneous process because the collision between photon and electron is considered to be a perfectly elastic collision. After this, you have to take into account the three conditions. Nu less than nu naught. When frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency. We know when frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency, photoelectric emission does not take place. Photoelectric emission agadela electron metal surface bit horage baralla. Yake anta helidre nodi, when frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency, according to equation 1 nodi, when frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency, andra frequency of incident light 5 hertz or 5 megahertz ela thagodu, and threshold frequency 10. Frequency of incident light is 5 and threshold frequency is 10. Hagadre ee case alli frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency. Avaga kinetic energy enaguttade 5 minus 10 will be minus 5 into h. Andre kinetic energy of photo electron become negative when frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency. Kinetic energy of photo electrons become negative. I have told you energies cannot be negative. Energy negative is energy negative. So this means that electron do not show any tendency to come out. Because kinetic energy of electron is negative in this case, electron do not show any tendency to come out of the metal surface. As a result, photoelectric emission does not take place. So when frequency of incident light is less than threshold frequency, kinetic energy of photoelectron become negative according to equation 1 prakara kinetic energy of photoelectrons become negative. What does it mean? It means that photoelectrons does not show any tendency to come out of the metal surface. So photoelectric emission is not going to take place. In the next case, when nu is equal to nu naught, when frequency of incident light is equal to threshold frequency. Suppose frequency of incident light is 5 and threshold frequency of the metal surface is also 5. When frequency of incident light is equal to threshold frequency, the kinetic energy of the photoelectron become 5 minus 5 is 0. The kinetic energy of the photoelectrons become 0. That means under this case, the electrons will just come out of the metal surface, but they will not be able to move. We can say the electrons come out of the metal surface with zero kinetic energy. Or we can say photoelectric emission is just possible. Photoelectric emission is just possible. Andre now kottiro energy ella electron metal surface inda horag barlakashte sakagutade. It will not be sufficient for the electron to move further. Adukke kinetic energy sigala. So when frequency of incident light is equal to threshold frequency, according to equation 1, kinetic energy of the photoelectrons become 0. This means electrons can just get ejected out of the metal surface with zero kinetic energy. And the other condition may be nu greater than nu. When frequency of incident light is greater than threshold frequency, say frequency of incident light is 15 and threshold frequency is 5. When frequency of incident light is greater than threshold frequency, you can observe the kinetic energy of photoelectrons become positive. This means photoelectric emission can take place. Electrons can get ejected out and photoelectric emission can take place. And if you go on increasing the frequency, you know, 15 minus 5 is 10. If you go on increasing the frequency of incident light, 25 meter, 15 in the 25 meter, kinetic energy becomes 20, 25 minus 20 is, sorry, 25 minus 5 is 20. You increase the frequency of incident light to 35, 35 minus 5 is 30. See, as you go on increasing the frequency of incident light, kinetic energy of photoelectrons goes on increasing. Other than our Lana graph, the kinetic energy of photoelectron is directly proportional to frequency of incident light. More is the frequency of incident light, more is the kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. So these are some of the explanations of loss of photoelectric effect using Einstein's photoelectric equation.